Yeah, your attacks excuse me, it's always going to bounce off the back of strong defensive display, and we've spoken about that. I'm more happy with the 8-minute effort. And I've been saying it for a number of weeks, and I'm sounding like a broken record, but you know, when we play 80 minutes of footy, we're a tough team. It's what cost us dearly at the start of the season. You know, 10-15 minute patches where we knocked off, but the last couple of weeks we've been very strong for 80.
I guess the scary thing is for other teams, I guess, a bit, is that a few errors still, so still a bit of improvement.
Oh, we've got a lot of improvement. You know, I thought we got a bit scrappy and a bit loose there at times today, and you know, sort of in those types of games, sometimes it's a little bit hard. And I thought they scored a couple of tries after half time off the back of a number of penalties that, you know, it was a kick and hope sort of thing, and they scored a couple of good tries off kicks, but they're difficult ones to defend.
Not at all concerned, Ricky, that those two tries after half time lead back to eight, that, you know, round one, you know, might be on the cards again.
You know, it's funny, I'm glad you asked the question, because I spoke about it after the game. If we were a mentally weak team, we would have started to get the shakes, and they didn't. The first thing I asked Brett was about their talk, and obviously that comes through good leadership from Jared. And that's, if you're mentally weak and start to think about what could happen because they're scoring a try, you know, I'd be worried as a coach. But they knew how they scored the tries, and they knew the scenario and how they got into those field positions. So I'm proud of the fact that I can say that, you know, we dug our heels in, and we got back into the game again by scoring, which is the best way to answer it.
Shannon was excellent off the bench, made a huge impact. He continues to sort of take on that role of, you know, being an interchange player and then not sort of griping the fact he's not starting.
Oh, look, he'd love to start. I'd love to start him too, but I just, at the moment, I can't start junior M board. It's not the balance that I want. I had to take him off. I mean, he's been linked to the Gold Coast for $650,000 a year. I had to take him off. I said to him when I bought him off, they want to give you $900 now, so I got him off to see if we can still try and keep him.
Not worried at all about Tarpanay on report there late for the tackle on James.
There was a tackle happened the other night, exactly the same, where his legs went up. He was in no danger at all, that player. His legs flipped up a touch, but he's in no danger at all because he landed a square fair on his back. And there was a tackle on the other night that didn't even cop a penalty. I'm interested to have a look at Jared being taken out. I mean, I haven't spoken to Jared about it yet, and he'll probably talk to you about it. Jared being taken out by Conrad. At the start of the game, I mean, that's either a penalty try or 10 minutes in the bin, going on the interpretations that we see at this stage.
Jared, I mean, your thoughts, obviously, as you're, you know, heading towards the ball, did you feel like you were sort of taken out?
Yeah, for sure. I definitely felt that because I wasn't really that close. We were probably a metre or two from the ball still. And yeah, I was just tossing up whether to take the two or the tap on it the whole time. It was sort of waiting.
You had 10 minutes.
Yeah, well, Moses Embiid got 10 minutes for a fingernail the other night, so...
And you?
And I got been, yeah, there's been a few symbiotics for a lot less, but you know, we just had to get on with it.
Mentioned Boydie, but I mean, obviously, Sia again, and a lot of the middles were massive. It must be really pleasing, you know, to sort of stand back and watch them just churn down the middle of the field.
Yeah, it is, mate. We've, you know, we've got a good rotation of interchange forwards coming on and lifting us just as much, like you said, Boydie and Donamis and Embiid in the second half were really good coming off the bench, and our starting middles were good. They you know, they get us going, and then when they are under the pump, our outside backs get in and do a lot of hard work for them, and in return they get up there on the kick chase and defend really well for us, so it's working really good at the moment, and you know, I'm just glad they're our forward pack.
Is it just that consistency that, you know, you really can't tell too much when the starters sort of leave and the bench comes on? Is that the biggest plus?
Yeah, look, it's a good thing to have. Obviously, you know, your forwards are going to get tight at some stage and get that rotation, but it's good to have guys like Shannon Boyd coming off the bench. And like Steve said, it's just a rotation that's working for us, and hopefully it gets working.
So, Ricky, there was a bit made of, I guess, the lock battle tonight. Josh popped off against John.
Yeah, David, it's funny that I didn't realise until today what you're saying, that about there was apparently a lot of media with Josh Papali and Jai Arrow, challenging for a State of Origin spot. I mean, Jai Arrow is a wonderful player, and you know he'll play Origin one day, maybe will be this year, but like when I was asked that today, I thought, you know, like, Josh Papali is proven, he's a State of Origin player. When Josh's weight's right and he's fit, he's an Origin player, international player every day of the week. His performance today, I asked him before the game, go and show everybody out there that you're an Origin player, mate. And he was wonderful in his, especially his first half, to set that 20-0 lead up. He was wonderful, Josh. And he's a big part of our club, and I just thought it was a bit, you know, no disrespect to young Arrow, but to have that sort of questioning on Josh fighting for a position for a young fella who's not at that level yet, well, you know, it was hands down today. I mean, I know the young bloke Jai got injured, and I hope he's okay, but Josh showed Kevy today that he's ready to get ready for his step up.
Yes, fair bit of the pack off contract at the end of the year. This performance today, I guess you hope you can hang on to all of them.
David, they are off contract, mate, and I want to keep every one of them. But I can't pay the huge money that has been offered to these boys. And if Junior and Bordy are getting this astronomical money from other clubs, they go with my best wishes. It's going to affect us as a football team. It's going to affect our club. I wanted to keep stability whilst I'm coaching here because I know stability will get you success at some stage. But the money that's been thrown around is astronomical for those two boys, and we can't match it. Simple as that. And if you know, the one thing I want to do here as a club now is I want players to be here for all the right reasons, not just for getting the most money. And that's got nothing to do with Junior or Shannon, but the money they've been offered is huge. So, you know, the Gold Coast, I mean, there was talk all week about the huge money for Shannon. I mean, they've got a number of other blokes up there that they should be looking at as well, because they're in their squad right now. And you can understand why a young bloke like Wallace would be a bit disgruntled in regards to where he's at. I mean, he's off contract, he's an Origin player too. But I just think that I've got to have a squad of players here who want to be a Raider as well.
There's a bit of talk around Papa as well.
Yeah, Papa's off contract, and we've offered Papa a very, very good deal. And, you know, fingers crossed, I hope that, you know, we get an answer on Josh very soon, and a number of the other boys. As I say, I want to keep them all, but we can't go paying that type of money because, you know, I won't have a football team.